Hello everyone, my name is Atre Sawant. I'm from third year ECC, roll number 29. So today we are going to learn about the topic meta materials. It's a really interesting topic. I'll try to cover it up in 5 minutes. So meta materials, this word comes from a Greek word, meta means beyond. So anything that is beyond material, like let's say you have a metal and a plastic. The combination of these two create another material that is meta material, but basically this new material will exhibit the properties of that particular material. So let's say that this is a XYZ metal and normal plastic, but the new material that has been formed will exhibit its own properties, not the previous properties. Now we'll look at a basic diagram of a meta material. So we'll see how it looks. This is a rough diagram. You can see that the specifics of the diagram, they are really unique. And the main important thing about the diagram is that because of its uniqueness, it exhibits some or the other kind of property that is basically it can manipulate electromagnetic waves. That is, it can control microwaves and other things. It literally can control them, like the amount which has been transferred. Moving on. Now we will see some of the more properties of metamaterials. Metamaterials, the main property that it involves is that main property is that it has a negative refractive index. For example, now, because of having a negative refractive index, the permeability is always negative because of the frequency. So, because of this, the one more huge advantage that the scientists have, taken from these metamaterials is that super lenses can be invented by these metamaterials. So, now usually the resolution gets blocked at diffraction limit. Whenever the super lens is what, how much far can you zoom from the object? But because of invention of metamaterials, this is now eradicated. Now scientists can go beyond the diffraction limit. Now last thing, that is the main use of metamaterials, which is kind of science fiction based, but people don't believe it. The last thing is that invisibility. Now most of you have seen the movie Harry Potter, that invisibility cloak. People thought that it won't be possible, but because of invention of metamaterials, some of that properties can be exhibited. For example, in 2005, a silver slab of 60 nanometer was used to observe image object of 60 nanometer. That is the size of 100 size of a red blood cell. So these are such kind of properties. And lastly, this metamaterial involves fields like electric engineering, classical optics, solid state, antenna engineering, and nanoscience. I hope you learned.